This is insanely hot. Oh my god.
I'm like hyperventilating.
I don't think I've ever experienced anything like this.
Hi, I'm Rishi Chiniga.
I'm Elias Kokinos.
And we're sports writers for StudLife.
Today, in the spirit of First We Feast Hot One, we're joined by head coach Pat Juckem of the WashU men's basketball team.
Yeah, we'll begin with the first wing. It's a plain Buffalo Wild Wing, nothing on it, just a little introduction. So
I appreciate the softball to start, guys.
Yeah.
Hopefully
yeah.
You stayed at that level.
So first question, can you touch on your first job as head coach of Manitowoc Roncalli High School, as well as teaching AP Psychology and Sociology?
Well, I will say I have an undergraduate degree in psychology, and I do think, I'm ill-equipped to dispense a ton of advice when it comes to psychological things. It is a really, I think just that appreciation for the individual differences. I think that's what I took away. And I think as I try to approach coaching and understanding our young men, they're each unique, how you go about, motivating, reaching them, helping them reach their full potential. It's not one size fits all. We're all complex human beings. And so I think it's that appreciation for differences that I've tried to be mindful of throughout my career and certainly continues here today at WashU.
I wanted to ask you something. In your last question, you sort of touched on the different complex personalities of the players, and one of the things that you've stressed is sort of having your team and your athletes keep their passion bucket full. I was wondering, is there a way that you're able to motivate an athlete who might not have their passion bucket full without overwhelming them, and how you have to judge the different type of personalities that you have on your team?
If you come into our gym, it's usually gonna be pretty loud. There's gonna be music playing for parts of it. We want to create an energetic, loud, hopefully fun atmosphere that our players are looking forward to being to. But we also being at, but also aware that there's some days where that bucket might be a little bit empty, and you're relying on teammates to hopefully kind of fill that thing up for you as well. My mama's gonna slap me after biting that.
Talking about passion, you've adopted the idea that student athletes need to either love it or live it basketball. Can you talk to us a little bit about the distinction between that and why it's so important to live basketball?
Sure, great question. And we're really fortunate. We've attracted a group of young men right now that they absolutely they live it and they love it. They're willing to do the extra. They're willing to and they're doing it not only for themselves, but they're doing it for each other. And I think that's like the secret of basketball. The secret of basketball has nothing to do with basketball. It's a group that's willing to sacrifice for one another, be selfless, be egoless. You can see it by how they conduct themselves and how they, I think outside observers would definitely recognize that about our group. He's doing tasty so far, gentlemen.
Let's see what this one is.
It's like a nice little hill.
Mm-hmm. Bit of a fun question for you. Give us a ranking of who on the team will be most likely to finish the Pornosaurus Pizza Challenge. And this challenge is a 28-inch pizza with two meats, and you get two people to finish it.
I would probably go with, for sure, the lead would be Drake Kinsvader. He is an endless pit. He definitely would be my captain of that group, and I would say with him, I'd probably have to go with one of our big guys. I'm gonna go with Kelvin Caprell. Who's just got a lot of places to put it at 6'11". So Drake and Calvin, but we have a lot of guys that would do a good job on that big pizza.
Maybe you could try it tonight.
Yeah, we will. We could. We will.
You will.
I'm feeling this one.
Bit more of a kick.
Yeah.
The sweetness kind of throws you off for a little bit, and then the heat kicks
in.
There's
a delay, a little delay.
Mm-hmm. A little time bomb action.
Hello.
Wow. In your office, you have a signed ball from President Bill Clinton sitting right next to a fathead of former player Charlie Jacob. Can you tell us a story about those two keepsakes and how they inspire you daily?
Yes. So I have a unique collection that I inherited from the Hall of Fame coach I followed, Mark Edwards. So there's actually, I think, six presidential balls in the office. And the cool thing is all those presidents actually signed the balls while standing in the office. They were all here for, most of them were for presidential debates. You know, it spoke to me a little bit, like, this is really, like, this is unique where we get to, what we get to do, who we get to interact with here at WashU. Yeah, Clinton was, I'm sure here is in a debate. You know, Charlie's definitely left his legacy, like many of our players have. But for just being an incredible teammate, I think he represents, kind of embodies what our program is. He was put his time in, had to kind of wait his term, but became a two-time UA Defensive Player of the Year, multi-all-conference, led his team in scoring, and if you talk to his teammates, they would laud him not for his accolades, but for his leadership. And so it's just a good reminder. It's kind of an accountability check that
yeah.
He's just kind of looking over, keeping track of us. Let's jump in. This one has me a little unnerved, guys.
Yeah, crippling agony does not really settle me down. In your basketball playing prime, do you think you could have played at WashU?
Wow, that's a good hard-hitting question. And, no, to be honest. Didn't get to see the WashU teams in that era, but know that they were very, very, very good, as we've been here historically. I was undersized, maybe before my time, player in terms of, I grew up as more of a interior player, post player, and eventually got out. But I was known mostly for setting illegal screens.
Okay.
Which is I have the body for, and I took a lot of pride in, actually. So, but I'll say this: I would have, knowing some of the players from the era that I'm in, the mid '90s, and the coach, it would have been a lot of fun to play with. That's for sure. They're great guys, and fortunately, they're very involved still. Our alumni are very involved in our program, so fortunate to have relationships with guys from my era.
One of the last two of our hottest sauces. This is Melinda's ghost pepper sauce.
I've heard some things about Melinda's. I don't know.
Have you?
Oh, look at you.
Looks like it's going to be.
You know what? If you're going to do it, I'll add on too.
All right. I'll. You know what? I can't let you guys do that without me participating. So pass it over.
Love to hear that.
Pass
Let's
it
go.
Over. I'm going to regret this. This to say. Oh gosh.
A little bit too much there.
I got a little much. Little much. All right.
Let's dig in.
Cheers, gentlemen.
Cheers.
Whoa. Yep.
That's hot.
We had the full effect.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
So when talking about some of the players right now, you mentioned the importance of their leadership qualities. Mm. And in one of the podcasts that you did, you said that when you recruit, you listen for voices and you look for their body language when they're on the court and when they're off the court and how they treat others and their teammates. Can you explain sort of a time when you saw that and it really changed your mind about a player and the importance, why obviously having a baseline level of skill is important, but also sure. The character to back it up?
Yeah, it is something. When we are out evaluating or recruiting, I always take note of players who are strong communicators. This is crushing me right now. Holy
smokes. It's hot.
Wow.
I can distinctly recall a young man who, I'm at an event, and I was actually not watching his court. There was a couple courts playing at the same time. And on the court adjacent, I could hear a voice. So there was someone that was, and I'm always attuned to that. So I just turned my focus over to thought, like, who's this communicator? But also watching, what I love to watch is when the young man is subbed out and he's sitting on the bench. Is he a great teammate? And that shows up in a couple of ways. Like, is he excited for his teammate's success? You know, is he, when he's sitting on the bench, is he just checked out? Or when someone else makes a great play, is he up, standing, clapping, you know, really engaged. When you have a group of people like that together, I just think it does create a pretty naturally strong environment, and I think we've done a pretty good job of attracting and evaluating that piece. And there is certainly a standard of talent that is required certainly to play for us, but that's not the only thing. And those other skills are every bit as valuable, if not even more so.
We have our last wing here. It's from a hot sauce roulette, and it's the 12th labeling of that hot sauce roulette. So just for the last one, I'm gonna put a little bit more on it. You're welcome to join us if you want to.
I'm already getting some really weird aroma coming out. Oh my gosh.
Oh man.
Okay. Let's have a fire extinguisher on hand.
Yeah. My mouth's gonna be
pass it over. I guess I'll
You doing it?
It's level 12.
Let's do this. I'm ready for this.
It comes out quite fast as well.
Oh god.
Okay, I'm gonna dab a little bit off, I think, and then take my bite.
Cheers, okay. Gentlemen.
Cheers.
It's been real.
Let's feast.
It's been real. Let's do this. Woo.
Oh.
Oh. Oh god. What did we get ourselves into? Oh my god.
Back up the milk wow. truck, please.
Yeah. I have hiccups. I have hiccups again.
Yeah, thank you.
More hiccups.
Appreciate you. Yeah. Can you top me off?
I got you.
I think I might start crying.
Damn.
Oh, it's so hot! What the hell?
Oh my goodness.
Okay, we're almost done. We gotta finish it.
Okay, I'm not going back in.
There is one more question. Give us some of your funniest stories from last season that you want to touch on.
It's really hard to concentrate on anything, but my mouth is so on fire right now. You guys feeling it as well? Elias, you okay?
Coach,
I'm a little worried about you, Elias.
Never been better, Coach.
I don't want to touch the milk, because I said I wouldn't.
You should touch the milk. It's really therapeutic and helpful.
I'm bringing it.
Wow, that was funny moments from last year. What do I think back to? Well, one that stands out near the end of our season. So we hosted two NCAA tournament games here. This is insanely hot.
Oh my god.
I'm like hyperventilating.
I don't think I've ever experienced anything like this.
I think I'm just sweating out of my eyes.
I can't have my hand starts to. Oh my god, my hand is shaking.
Okay, last year, NCAA tournament games, we won two in overtime to advance. So after you advance, there's a bracket posted on a wall outside of our field house. And you've seen it, you know, after a team wins in advance in the tournament, they give them their name and they go slap it on the bracket, right? We had a mini bracket. And so our team's in the hallway huddled. And our athletic director, Anthony Asba, presents our sticker to Calvin, Capril. And he either wasn't aware of the process that you need to go slap it on, or he kind of just held it in his hands like, well, what do I do with this? And everyone's like, yo, put it on the bracket, man, we just advanced. So it was just kind of funny how he was, I think, caught up in the moment, a little bit unaware of what we wanted. You know, we had so many moments with our group last year, and whether it be highlights of going to New York to start the season, getting a couple big wins out there. But I think the things you remember, and quite honestly, you know, it's hard to even pick one or two, but the moments that if you ask our guys to take away aren't really the wins and losses or the big, it's really all the other stuff. It's probably something I said, you know, you guys okay?
You're doing really well, honestly. You're handling this pretty well. I won't lie.
Far better than I am. Anyway.
Yeah.
We're doing this together, guys.
Yeah, that's true.
But the moments in between are really what we all take away from these experiences. It's not, you know, the big wins as much. Those are great.
Don't touch your ass.
You know, when you're hanging out with a couple guys eating ridiculous wings that are burning your face off, that's what I'm going to remember from. He asked me this question a year from now. I think I'm going to probably cite this experience right here because this is highly memorable.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure what's going on internally right now. I don't know about you guys, but it's not going great.
I'm hasn't going quite hit straight the to the yet. Bathroom, I think, yeah. after this.
It hasn't hit the stomach for you, you said?
Yeah, no, it's there for me.
All right, Coach, thank you so much for your time. This camera, that camera. Let the WashU community know what's the plans for WashU men's basketball.
We're really excited to get our season started. 7 o'clock in the field house. We love when our students come out. You make such a big difference. And so we invite you back to come and just cheer on your fellow WashU Bears.
Great.
Wow. Awesome.
Thank you so Good much. Job. Holy.
Thank you so
I want to kill myself.
Insane. I won't lie to you. I don't know how you're handling this so well.
I think this is a little bit
You have so many Elias you're doing. I'm like, I gotta be a little better than that. But you went crazy.
That was nuts.
Oh my goodness.
I've never done anything like that.
Are you lightheaded right now? I kind of am.
My whole mouth. Dying.
My house, so yeah, that's true too.
Wow.